chance of knowing God for yourself. Thank you, ushers. Amen. The importance of knowing God for yourself. Amen. The writer of this psalm has a settled, non-negotiable conviction concerning the existence of God. There is no doubt in his mind that God is real. Regardless of what others may say or think, no matter what others may doubt, how many may fight against his belief, he will not change what he knows to be true. David is the writer of this psalm. And as we read this psalm, he makes it crystal clear as to whom he is addressing. He makes it clear to whom he speaks. It's obvious, brothers and sisters, that he's talking to God. Listen to what he says in the beginning of this psalm. He says, O Lord, thou hast searched me and known me. And throughout this psalm, he's talking solely to God. He lets us know that he has a personal relationship with God. I mean, if you notice the length and breadth of this psalm, you'll see how he constantly uses personal pronouns as well as possessive pronouns. He constantly uses the words I, my, and me. If you'll allow me, let me show you. O Lord, thou hast searched me and known me. Thou knowest my down city and mine uprising. Thou understandest my thought afar off. Thou compassest my path and my lying down, and art acquainted with all my ways. For there is not a word in my tongue, but lo, O Lord, thou knowest it all together. Thou hast beset me behind and before, and laid thine hand upon me. Such knowledge is too wonderful for me. It is high. I cannot attain unto it. Whither shall I go from thy spirit? Or whither shall I flee from thy presence? If I ascend up into heaven, thou art there. If I make my bed in hell, behold, thou art there. If I take the wings of the morning and dwell in the uttermost parts of the sea, even there shall thy hand lead me, and thy right hand shall hold me. If I say, surely the darkness shall cover me, even the night shall be light about me. Yea, the darkness hideth not from thee, but the night shineth as the day. The darkness and the light are both alike to thee, for thou hast possessed my reins. Thou hast covered me in my mother's womb. I will praise thee, for I am fearfully and wonderfully made. Marvelous are thy works, and that my soul knoweth right well. My substance was not hid from thee when I was made in secret and curiously wrought in the lowest part of the earth. Thine eyes did see my substance, yet being imperfect, and in thy book all my members were written, which in continuance were fashioned when as yet there was none of them. How precious also are thy thoughts unto me, O God. How great is the sum of them. If I should count them, they are more in number than the sand. When I awake, I am still with thee. Surely thou wilt slay the wicked, O God. Depart from me, therefore, ye bloody men, for they speak against thee wickedly, and thine enemies take thy name in vain. Do not I hate them, O Lord, that hate thee? And am not I grieved with those that rise up against thee? I hate them with perfect hatred. I count them mine enemies. Search me, O God, and know my heart. Try me and know my thoughts, and see if there be any wicked way in me, and lead me in the way everlasting. You ought to know by now who he's talking to and who he's talking about. It's personal. Everybody need to have a personal relationship with God. Are y'all with me here? Old folks, you say you need to get to know God while the blood is running warm in your veins. Now, throughout this song, I see here that he talks about God's attributes. And in reference to his relationship with God, he talks about the attributes of God. Notice this, first of all, in verses 1 through 4, he simply says, God searches me. Listen, that he says, Lord, you know me. You know when I sit down. You know when I get up. You know my thoughts are far off. You are acquainted with me, my manners, and everything about me. You know what I say. You know what words come out of my mouth. He's simply saying that God knows everything. God is all knowing. Another way of saying that is God is omniscient, which means God knows all. Church, think about it. There isn't anything that God does not know. God knows everything, and he knows everything about you. Look at it. He knows our movements. He knows what we do. You can't do anything and hide it from God. God knows everything you've done. He knows everything you do. And he knows everything you're gonna do. Are y'all with me here? Yes. Not only does he know our movements, he knows our motives, which means he knows everything that crosses your mind. He knows what you think about. He knows all your thoughts of the past. He knows all your thoughts in the present. And he even knows your future thoughts. He knows what you're going to think about, and you don't even know yourself, because he knows your thoughts. He knows our motives. He knows our intentions. He knows our hidden agendas. Are y'all listening to me? Not only does he know our motive, but he knows what comes out of our mouth. He knows our words. He knows what we say. Yes, my brothers and sisters, and that behooves us to be careful what you say. Because you can't say anything that God is not aware of. Yes, don't say something that you wouldn't want God to hear. Yes, he knows what comes out of our mouth. He hears us when we say stuff we ought not say. Even if you don't say it where somebody can hear, God heard you anyhow. Are y'all listening to me? He hear you when you talk good about somebody. But he also hear you when you talk bad about somebody. Yes, he knows what comes out of your mouth. But not only that, he also knows the mess that we get in. Yes, God knows when we have ourselves in a bad situation. There isn't anything about you that God does not know. Now, this is scary for a sinner, but it's joy for a saint. I'm glad I serve a God who knows everything about me. When folk trying to figure you out, God already know you. When people assume you're this or that, God already know what you are. Like the songwriter said, I am what God said I am. Are y'all listening to me? Now what folks say you are may not be true, but what God say you are, that's what you are. If God say you a liar, you a liar. If God say you're righteous, you're righteous. If God say you a thief, you a thief. Whatever God say you are, that's what you are. Because he knows you. He is the God who searches me. But then he, in verses 5 through 12, he lets me know that he's the God who surrounds me. Because he says that he's in all places. He says, where can I go to get away from you? God is everywhere at the same time. In other words, he is what we call omnipresent. Yes, listen, wherever you go, when you get there, he's already there. God is everywhere. Yes, everybody needs to know about what we call the everywhereness of God. God is so big, he's everywhere, that it seems like he bumps into himself, because he's from everlasting to everlasting. Wherever you go, you think you done got away from God. God said, I'm already here. You can't get away from me, because he's in all places at the same time. No matter where you go, he's so high you can't go over. He's so low you can't go under him. He's so wide you can't get around him, because he's everywhere. Yes, yes. Don't you hear him saying, every sinner need to know, you can't get away from me. Yes, you can't get away from God. Even when you think you've gotten away, you're going to find out that God's still with you. That you're going to keep running in the dark. Yes, yes, listen to what he says. He says, if I ascend up in the heaven, you are there. If I make my bed in hell, you are there. Another way of saying that, looking at that, is even through death, you can't get away from God. Some folks think, well, if I just die, I won't be bothered with nobody. Wait a minute. You still got to meet God. Even death can't exempt you from meeting God. Yes, but then this text should also be interpreted as saying, even when you go through the good times, God is there. But then when you have to go through hell, troublesome times, God is there. And I don't know about you, but I'm glad I serve a God who will be there for me through good times and through bad. He's there. Yes. And then distance can't get you. you away from God. No matter where you go, He is there. Yes, you can't get away from God even by trying to hide in the darkness. You know, some folk love creeping in the dark. Some folk don't come out till it's night. Are y'all listening to me? There are a lot of folk, they like to do their due behind the curtains of the darkness. But I stop by to tell you, you ain't hiding from God, because the darkness and the light look the same to Him. God can see you just as good in the dark. Are y'all listening to me? You can't hide from God. Yes, I'm glad He said, Lord, you are everywhere. You are with me. You surround me, which means that God is in front of me. And I need God in front of me to clear out and take care of what I have to meet. God is also behind me. God is there because He got my back, and He cleaned up everything I messed up. But God is also beside me. He's there walking with me to hold me up when I'm falling down. Yes, I'm glad I serve a God who's always with me. He promised He would never leave us nor forsake us. It's good news to know whatever you face in life, when others turn their back on you, God is still there. He's still there. You can't get away from Him. And oh, I wouldn't want to be apart from Him. Yes, when nobody else is with me, I can count on God. I know He'll be there. But then finally, He said, not only does He search me and know everything about me, not only, my brothers and sisters, does He surround me, meaning that He's always with me. But He says in verses 13 through 18, He shaped me. He made me. That's why He said, I will praise You, because I am fearfully and wonderfully made. This speaks of Him being powerful. This testifies to the fact that God has all power. Yes, the term we use is He is omnipotent. He's got all power. Hallelujah. He created me. He created me. He made me. Can't nobody make another me, because God made me. We don't believe in evolution. We believe in creation. Yes, there are those who doubt creation, but they are wrapped up in evolution. Yes, saying that man came from a monkey. Ain't no monkey ever look this good. We ain't come from no monkey. There are those who are wrapped up in the theory of evolution. One evolutionist is so wrapped up in the theory of evolution that he wrote a poem that said, once I was a tadpole beginning to begin. Then I became a frog with my tail tucked in. Then I became a monkey in a banyan tree. Now I am a professor with a PhD. That's what they think. But man was never a tadpole. Man ain't never been a monkey. God made man. He wanted you to be. Am I right about it? Oh, my brothers and my sisters, God created. you have come from God.
Yes, sir.
Everything you are, God made you. Everything you know, God taught you. Everything you have, he gave it to you. Every situation you come through, he brought you. Where you are right now, he made it all possible. No wonder I can concur with the psalmist when he said, if it had not been for the Lord who was on my side, I would have been swallowed up by my enemies. Yes, God made you. God covered you. He said he covered me in my mother's womb. He caused me to exist. He said, you're no accident. God put you here. Amen. A lot of folk didn't make it, but you and I made it. We were able to get here because God made it all possible. He said, I was curiously wrought. In other words, he gave me everything I needed. Yes, he gave me fingers. He gave me hands. He gave me arms. He gave me everything I needed. I got hips, I got thighs. I got knees, I got legs, I got feet. He gave it all to me. Am I right about it? And oh, my brothers and sisters, everything you got, God gave it to you. He gave you eyes, ears, nose, mouth. Am I right about it? Can't nobody do for you what God has already done. Am I right about it? You can't be duplicated. They can't make a carbon copy. Ain't God all right? Yes, he gave you a heart. He gave you veins. He gave you blood. He gave you corpuscles. He gave you everything that you need. He gave you a brain. Ain't God all right? He gave you neck bone, shoulder bone. He gave you hip bone, leg bone, foot bone. Thank God for these bones. And God knows how to shake bones. If E. Lickle will stop by, he'll tell you that the power in his word can shake dry bones. He's able to shake you up. Am I right about it? Well, I'm through now. But as I close, yeah, it means everything to know God for yourself. Because the psalmist goes on to say, my brothers and my sisters, that the Lord keeps me on his mind. In verses 17 and 18, yes, he said, the Lord is always thinking about me. And oh, I don't know about you, but that's good news to me. Yes, not a day goes by without me being on the Lord's mind. Am I right about it? And all of you in here, yes, the only reason why you were able to wake up this morning is because the Lord had you on his mind. When he got ready to give people eyesight, he had you and I on his mind. Am I right about it? When he got ready to give people their right mind, he had you and I on his mind. Hey God, all right. I realize that God is busy taking care of all of creation. I know that God is busy healing folk who are sick. I know that God is busy answering prayers. But out of all that he does, I'm glad to know the Lord still took time to keep me on his mind. Ain't God all right? And since the Lord always have you on his mind, you ought to make it your business to have him on your mind. Ain't God all right? Like the song songwriter said, you ought to be able to wake up saying, I woke up this morning with my mind stayed on Jesus. Thank God, all right. Anybody here know when you keep him on your mind, he can keep your mind. Thank God, all right. I got the clothes, but I hear him saying, I will praise you because of who you are. I will praise you because of where you are. I will praise you because of what you've done. Thank God, all right. Because I know, God, you have all in the palm of your hand. Thank God, all right. You're all knowing. You're in all places. You got all power. Have I got a witness here? And when Jesus came on the scene, the Bible said he went about healing and he did good. When he went to a wedding at Cana of Galilee, when he turned water into wine, he used some power. Am I right? When he healed lepers, he used some power. When he raised the dead, he used some power. But when he rose from the grave, I heard him say, all power is in my hand. Ain't God all right? He got power to get you through your tough times. Power to turn your midnights to midday. To make your enemy your footstool. Power to heal your sickness and give you health. Power to make a crazy man say, thank God, all right. He got power to save a soul that's hell bound. He got power to bring a dead church to life. Thank God, all right. He got power. Do you know he got power? And so as I go to my seat, I'm glad I know God. And I'm glad he know me. Anybody here glad? He know you. He understand you. He know what's going on with you. And he's able to help you. Won't he do it?